today we are talking about the new Home Assistant 2023.5, and this release is almost fully dedicated to the Year of the Voice Chapter 2, so it is full of new voice related stuff that are pretty exciting in my own opinion. I will start with the least exciting new features and I will gradually move to the most exciting ones, so make sure that you watch the entire video till the very end. First new feature is small and it is only available if you are having a Home Assistant Yellow. You can now configure the LEDs of the disc, heartbeat and power of your Yellow by using the configure button on the settings hardware page. Next, few integrations are moved from manual YAML configuration to configuration through the user interface, which makes them more easier to use. These integrations are Android TV Remote, Array, PT, Bluetooth, Voice over IP, Wyoming and Roborock. We will talk about Wyoming later in details, but the second most exciting among these new integrations is the new Roborock integration. Till the moment there was a Xiaomi integration which was fully local and it covered most of the Roborock vacuum cleaners. But using the Roborock app and at the same time the Home Assistant Xiaomi integration was not possible with the previous releases. Now, with the new Roborock Home Assistant integration, you can use the Roborock app, which offers more features for your vacuum cleaner, and simultaneously you can have that device added in Home Assistant. And moving forward, webhooks are extended to support the Get HTTP method. And that's not all. Some great security features to the webhook triggers are also added. Now you have the ability to set which HTTP methods your webhook trigger to use and to limit them to only work on your local network. And here comes the good part. The voice commands in the assist accessible from the upper right was not working well on all popular browsers until now. Starting from Home Assistant 2023.5, when you click on that mic, you'll be sent to an assist pipeline. This pipeline can be created and configured from the Home Assistant menus, and it basically does three different things. It converts speech to text, it processes the text and gets some responses from that processing and then convert that text back in audio. So there is an audio response as well now and not only text that was presented in the previous releases.
Turn on kitchen lights.
Turned on light.
But there is more. From 2023.5, in the settings of the Home Assistant, we have a new menu called Voice Assistants, where you can configure the above mentioned pipelines. Just for information, if you have enabled the Home Assistant subscription service, you have a pre-configured cloud pipeline for you that will be ready to be used. But the more interesting part to me here is how to create a local pipeline and is it going to work well. To help you make a local assist pipeline, there are two new add-ons available in the Home Assistant add-on store. And attention here, if you don't have Home Assistant yet, or you have it but you don't have add-on store, then register for my upcoming webinar where you will understand everything essential about the different installation types of Home Assistant. Also, what are their pros and cons and where add-on store is present. Back to the add-ons. These new add-ons are called OpenAI Whisper and Piper, where Whisper can help you with speech-to-text and Piper can help you with text-to-speech part. To make everything local, you will need one more thing, a new integration named Wyoming that we mentioned earlier. This integration provides a way for Home Assistant to integrate with voice, text-to-speech and speech-to-text services that use the Wyoming protocol. And such services are the above mentioned Piper and Whisper add-ons. Having the Whisper and Piper add-ons as well as the Wyoming integration in Home Assistant is all that is needed and you can finally make that local pipeline which will be then used by Home Assistant Assist. To create the Assist pipeline you can click on the Assist icon and then on Manage Assistants, which will lead you to the same Settings Voice Assistant menu. From there you can add a new assistant, after that you can name your Assist pipeline, you can select different language, select conversion agent and also speech to text and text to speech providers. In our case, Whisper and Piper. Finally, you can set that assist pipeline as preferred and from now on you can control your Home Assistant with your voice through your browser locally. One important remark here, to see that microphone icon you have to access your Home Assistant over HTTPS or from localhost which is also considered secure. Thanks Baloop for that info. It is also possible to use an analog phone or a compatible device running ESP Home like M5 Stack Atom Echo, but more on that in my future videos. One more interesting thing in the voice assistant's menu is the Expose tab. You can control which entities are exposed to your voice assistant from here. It currently supports Assist, Amazon Alexa and Google Assistant, where the latter two are only working if they are set up using the Home Assistant cloud. Don't forget to download my smart home glossary if some of the smart home words or terms that I'm using are not so clear for you. Thank you for watching, I'm Kirill, see you next week.
Bye!